Hi guys, Zach from High Performance Academy here. Welcome along to today's members webinar. Thanks heaps for joining us. A couple of interesting wiring bits and pieces to go through with you today. We're going to look at depinning and pinning, a couple of common connector styles. So I've got a couple of OEM connector styles here and a couple of more aftermarket connector styles as well. Going to have a look at what we need to get the pins into and out of them safely, as it can be a pretty common thing that you might actually want to be reusing some of these connector bodies. Before we get into that though, have a little bit of a catch up about what's been going on here at HPA over the last week. So we have been thoroughly deserted here in the office. Andre, Ben and Jono have all shot away to America to the PRI trade show. So they're going to be getting a lot of footage and a lot of really, really in-depth industry interviews over there that's going to help us put out a lot of content over the next couple of months. So apparently they're having an amazing time. I'm seeing a lot of updates come through on our staff chat that make you pretty jealous, to be honest. So good on them, and really looking forward to seeing some of that content come out. They are having a meetup while they're over there as well, because we know that HPA, we've got a pretty global audience, but we are tucked away down here in the beautiful corner of the world that is New Zealand. So they are planning a meetup over in Indianapolis on the 7th or the 9th of December. The guys will confirm that one in the chat. And if you are interested in going along to that, the guys are going to throw up a link where you can RSVP. Just a bit of a meetup, catch up with the guys, say hey. We talk about where HPA is going and what we're up to. I'm sure they'd absolutely love to see you there. Other things going on here at HPA, our SRZ project, or the SR20 that we're building and putting into our 350Z race car for endurance racing, is well underway, and it's really coming along really well. The car is away at a fab shop at the moment, which is just through the Kararau Gorge over in Cromwell at a fabrication shop called Hillside Fabrication. These guys have been absolutely fantastic to work with so far, really, really keen, really open, so everything is going really well. In fact, if we just pop over to my laptop quickly, got a couple of pictures here that they've sent me today of last week. We got the motor actually slung in to the engine bay, but they have gone ahead and welded up some engine mounts now. So we've finalized the position of the engine, and they've made us some really, really nice engine mounts here. Done a pretty stellar job of them by the look of it. So that's going to keep everything nice and well in place for the endurance racing that this motor is likely to see. Going to be pretty stiffly mounted, as it's actually going to be quite a tight fit with the turbo on here and the intake manifold on the other side to the false firewall in the Z33 engine bay. So we have gone with a urethane mounting solution here. That is going to give us a little bit of isolation from the really high frequency vibrations, but things are going to be pretty stiff because we don't want this moving around too much and things hitting the engine bay. One interesting thing that they did find was when we had the old engine out and the old engine mounts removed, the subframe underneath here was actually quite nastily cracked through the bolt hole location where the original engine mount for the original Z33 engine was sitting. So that could be because the 350Z in question had actually, the motor in that had actually done pretty high Ks, and it was a bit of a, you know, it was a dyno mule and a test mule as well, so a lot of those Ks were pretty harsh. So we've had that, they've TIG welded that up for us, and they're going to put a reinforcement plate on top of the cross member as well, help spread some of that load around this section here, and make sure we don't strike that problem again. As of right now, they're working on the gearbox mount for our TTI sequential, getting that nice and high up in the transmission tunnel, so we can create a good linkage solution to get a nice gear shift feel on that. So that's going to be another fun project in and of itself. I have been beavering away here working on the professional motorsport wiring course as well. This has been a massively requested course, and ideally I would have actually liked to come in and make this course straight off the bat when I started with HPA, but we really needed to go through the process of getting our wiring fundamentals course and then our club level course done, as it is a little bit of a progression step up to this course. So we're going to have some amazing dropping really, really valuable information in there for anyone that's wanting to build wiring harnesses to a more professional motorsport standard, as that sort of is my actual background. Picture I've got here is of a concentrically twisted harness section. This was a sample harness section that I build in the course, and I'm talking about how I'm going about branching this out. And particular in this instance, I'm talking about the fact that a lot of the time your branch sections here aren't going to be amazingly pretty or tidy. It is the nature of the beast that quite often you're going to have wires coming out from a central section of the harness, and that is absolutely totally okay. These sections still have to be strain relieved, but they don't have to be amazingly tidy. We are going to wrap this all in capped on tape to keep it well strain relieved, and then there's going to be a sheathing and booting solution that goes over top of that as well. A couple of other really, really good key bits of info we're cramming into that course for you is about potting a sensor or actuator that you're wanting to use in a race application that doesn't have a connector that is really suitable or up to the task. Quite often what you find with the OEM style of connectors is that they'll withstand the chemicals and possibly even the heat that they might see in a race application, but it's those vibrations that an engine being driven really hard put out that actually cause them to fail. So potting can be a really good solution to this problem. You actually install a flying lead onto the connector pins and use some epoxy sealing compound to completely enclose that join that you've made in there, which is actually a soldered join. As controversial as that can be, we go with solder there because it's a really reliable connection method once it's been totally encased in this potting compound. It means we're not going to get any of those fractures from vibration. And then you can finish the whole thing off with a bit of Rakem SCL for a nice boot as well. So those are a couple of demonstrations we'll be going through in that professional level wiring course. So look out for that one. We are aiming to have it out by the end of the year, and there will be a good introductory offer on that as well. So watch out for that email. A lot of work is going into it, and I genuinely think it's going to be a bit of a banger. I'm really looking forward to actually watching through some of the final edits myself, because I think it's going to give some really valuable and reliable information out there to the people that want to be building those wiring harnesses to that higher level. Information that can actually be a little bit tricky to find in other places. It does seem like the motorsport wiring world can be a little bit closed off. It can be hard to find good, reliable information on techniques that are used at that higher level. So that's what we're definitely trying to get out there. We have had a giveaway over the last couple of weeks for a Plex display and their Nokmon V2 that has actually now finished up. So we'll be drawing the winner of that in the next week and putting out an email letting that person know. And we'll have a follow-up about that as well. I can't mention what the next giveaway is going to be quite yet, but I can say keep an eye out for it because it is going to be an ECU and it's going to be a real good one. If I didn't work here, I would absolutely be doing everything I could to enter it because it is going to be a really, really sweet giveaway. That would be the majority of what's been going on here at HPA over the last week. So we've got the three guys away, going to try and get things a bit cleaned up and have it nice for them when they come back. And really looking forward to that and getting stuck back into things and getting that wiring course out as well. So if you just give me a minute here, I'll get things set up. Just a quick reread through my notes, drink of water, and we'll head into today's webinar.